Hello everyone and welcome back to another Kerbal Space Program video with me, Oofle Spoofle, and in today's episode of Modded Career, we're going to start things off with another launch of our Enceladus launch vehicle, which is in fact the same one that we used to send our Kerbals to the Mon in the last episode, but we're going to be using it for a slightly different reason. And yeah, for this time, we're going to be going interplanetary for the first time in this series. And exactly what we are doing is we're going to be sending a probe to Duna. Now, I designed this probe on a live stream I did a few days ago, closer to a week at this point. But if you want to watch back the live stream, it's about 2 hours. But if you really want to watch it, then feel free. I do have a past live streams playlist, I believe. I've only done two. But yeah, anyway, so the reason I'm using Enceladus is because it's a fairly heavy payload. It's decked out with a lot of scientific equipment, and it's also got a tiny little Duna lander in there as well. And also, the Enceladus has a very powerful upper stage, meaning that we do have that extra Delta V to put us onto an encounter with Duna. So there you go. Now you can see our satellite. And as you can see, it's got a lot of equipment. I've got basically all the science experiments I can get. I've got some ScanSat instruments. It's got loads of antennas because, I don't really have the best antennas unlocked, so we're going to have to go with, like, multiple low-power ones. And then, of course, we've got a lot of electricity to supply this thing. Now, we are just going to be getting this thing onto a course with Duna. We're not going to be getting it there and landing and everything and getting into orbit in this episode because I need to actually upgrade my tracking station before I can really try to operate this. At the moment it's level 2, I want to try and at least get it up to level 3 before I start using everything, just so that my data transmission is going to be hopefully a little bit faster, because I don't even know if I'll be able to get signal at this, you know, but if I get there with a level 2 tracking station, I don't even know if I'll be able to have signal at all, and if I don't, then that's going to be really bad. But yeah, there we go, we have our Duna encounter set up. And then the second launch is going to be another Enceladus, actually. And as you can see in the bottom right, we do have Jebediah and Bill making their return to crewed spaceflight. And as you can see, we're actually launching from the desert launch site instead of the Kerbal Space Center. And this is because our destination is going to be Minmus. And you might be wondering why I'm at the desert launch site. And that's because it's actually quite a good latitude to launch into the orbital plane of Minmus. Now, I know that by launching from the equator, you can access literally any inclination, but I just thought, you know, I'd change things up a little bit and launch from the desert launch site instead, because it's basically, you know, it's on a 6.5, its latitude is 6.5 degrees south, and Minmus's inclination is 6 degrees. So if we can launch into a 6 degree orbit, then that means we won't have to do any orbital, you know, like, inclination changes on our way to Minmus, you know, assuming that you actually launch at the right time, which I did fairly well in this. I mean, I still had to do a bit of a correction, but it ended up being a bit more efficient. At least I hope so. And I also have to, I really need to fix that interstage on Enceladus, because I think 3 times in a row, or at least 2 times in a row, my engine is kind of clipped into that interstage, and it kind of gets stuck, and you end up having to blow it up with your engine exhaust. And I also forgot a launch escape tower on this. Luckily, we didn't end up needing it. We didn't end up needing it on our first launch of Enceladus either. And to be honest, like, if something does go wrong, since we are using liquid-fueled engines, we can literally just, you know, shut it down, deploy the fairing, and then, you know, jettison the capsule. I don't really think we need a launch escape tower, to be honest. But anyway, we can go ahead and do our Transminmus injection. And, I mean, in hindsight, it might have been more logical to go to Minmus before the Mon, because, you know, Minmus does actually take less Delta V to do a round trip than, you know, when compared to the Mon. But I guess one reason why I didn't want to go to Minmus first is because you need extra mass in the form of life support, because, you know, the Mon, at least in my last video, the Mon was a 3-day mission for the Kerbals. This one ended up being more like 18 days, so they can't survive off of just, you know, the inbuilt food and water in the command module. You do have to bring a bit extra. So that's why I have that service bay just below the command module there. It has some other stuff in it. I think we've got some monoprop tanks, we've got a bunch of science experiments, and we have a little mystery payload, which will be revealed in just a second here. But yeah, we can go ahead and do our orbital insertion, still using that Enceladus upstage, because it has plenty of delta V. Originally, I planned to use the lander to do the orbital insertion, but I just packed way too much delta V in this upper stage, so yeah. I just did a small deorbit burn with that upper stage and then jettisoned it, and then we can go ahead and use this lander. And yeah, it looks like I don't have the ultra terrain shaders loaded for some reason. Like, I have them on, they were even working on Kerbin, so I don't really know what's happened to them here. Because, yeah, we haven't really got the nicest looking textures here, but oh well, such is life. I could have gone to, you know, the main menu and try and fix it, but honestly, can't be bothered to do that. But anyway, yeah, it's a Minmus landing. They're really easy to do, because Minmus's gravity is so low, you really don't have much to worry about. We have plenty of delta V, and I almost messed up this landing at the end when I kept my smart ISS on retrograde instead of up. But anyway, now we can deploy our mystery payload, and any second now, yes, that is that's a microsat, which is just gonna pop out onto the surface. And the reason I have this is because I have the seismic scan experiment unlocked, but the thing is that it takes 14 days to complete, and I don't think my Kerbals really want to stay on the surface of Minmus for 14 days waiting for the experiment to complete. So instead, I just decided to have, you know, deploy a probe on the surface. It didn't end up being too heavy, so, you know, it was absolutely fine. But anyway, we've got a flag on the MUN already, so now it's time to get our second flag of the series, of course, on the surface of Minmus. And again, it's going to be Jebediah planting it. And this time, Bill is going to be tasked with setting up our ground station. And this time, I did remember to bring an actual experiment instead of two control stations, which was, yeah, that was the mistake I made last time, meaning that I could not get any of the surface deployed science from the MUN. But luckily, I did manage to get it all working. I did make sure to check that the goo monitor was actually connected to the control station, because sometimes that doesn't happen. Like, sometimes you'll have everything set up, you'll have, you know, the right amount of electricity, and then it just doesn't want to connect. That happened during a simulation using the crash mod. Maybe that's to do with the fact that it's a simulation. I honestly don't know. I don't use the ground stations much, although I do really like them, and I should probably use them a bit more. But anyway, I've rambled through that entire EVA basically, and we're now getting into orbit. And for some reason here, MechJeb decided it would just make my craft do this, whatever that was. I was like not touching anything at that point, so I'm not sure what was going on there. And it put me onto, you know, if you look at the top left, you can see I'm on a highly eccentric orbit now. I guess that's Minmus for you, like, like you lose control for 1 second and oh, you're on an escape trajectory. Although here I did decide that I'm actually in a very good place to just escape Minmus and, you know, go for a re-entry into Kerbin. So I did just that. So yeah, goodbye Minmus. It was, didn't spend very long on there actually. But anyway, we can of course re-enter into Kerbin's atmosphere. My periapsis was a bit low here. It really didn't need to be this low. I just overshot and I couldn't be bothered to correct for it. So yeah, I mean, to be honest, anything between sort of 35,000 meters and, you know, a direct impact with Kerbin is absolutely fine. You just get varying levels of G-forces. And somehow, I mean, this went up to like 6 Gs or something, and I guess my Kerbals are pretty strong because they managed to survive these G-forces without blacking out. I know I didn't have the Kerbal G-force tolerance enabled there, but then I realized that and then I turned it on. But anyway, as much as I do like splashing down the ocean, we are going to be in the deserts for this one, which in my opinion doesn't look quite as cool. I just think there's something really satisfying about splashing down in the ocean, but that's just my personal preference. I don't think the Kerbal's really mine personally. Of course, we have those two radially mounted parachutes, and they look really cool with restock. That's a mod that basically gives all the stock parts new textures, and in my opinion, they look a lot better, and especially a lot more realistic. I think that's one of the main selling points of the mod. But there we go, Jebediah and Bill have returned home from the surface of Minmus. So guys, that's going to do it for this video. Hopefully you enjoyed. If you did, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, leave a comment, all of that good generic YouTube stuff. Make sure to check out my Discord if you want to. There's a link in the description. But anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And until next time, have a great rest of your day.